Hello everyone. In today's topic, we are going to solve some very important numericals regarding this particular energy economics. So as in the previous class and the previous video, as we have already seen, some basic concepts actually we have already learned about this particular energy economics, that is how to perform the financial analysis. Clear? So we have already talked about whenever we are planning for any energy efficiency or energy management project, whatever the costs that are involved should always be considered. Okay, so the type of investment that a particular management is actually proposing to put in a particular organization, so for a particular project, so it is also trying to find out how much return on investment is going to get on the capital that he has invested. So whoever the energy auditor, if we talk about whenever he's advising the management people of the organization that let us invest a particular amount of money or a particular amount or capital, it should be invested in a particular area, that is maybe a new boiler plant, for example. So the management is going to ask two questions, that is how much is the proposal is going to cost and how much money will be saved if I it will be saved if I am going to implement this particular proposal. So when the concept of cost is coming into picture, there are two things which will always strike our mind, that is what is fixed cost and what is variable cost. Because when we add fixed cost and variable cost, the total cost of any of the projects can be easily found out. So remember, the basic difference is the variable cost is that particular cost which varies directly with the output of the particular plant or the production process. So the variable cost is totally depending. It is totally depending upon your output. So for example, if the variable cost is totally dependent, it is depending upon the output of the company. It is clear. So for example, if your production is high, ultimately the raw material cost, consumption will be more. So ultimately raw material cost will be more. If your production is low, raw material cost will become less. So that raw material cost will come under variable cost. I hope you understood. So what I'm trying to say is, so fixed cost are those costs which is which is not dependent upon the plant or process output. So it is totally, that means it is that cost is not going to get affected with the production process, whether the production process is very high or very less, whether the company is going in profit, the loss, so fixed cost is not going to hamper. So, like the site rent or the insurance, or maybe for a particular company, you bought a particular site, that total money is getting blocked up as a fixed cost. Okay. So, today, let us, based on this particular concept, let us do a particular problem which is based on this energy economics. Clear? So before that, let me share the screen with you. Now here, when we talk about, or when we are actually thinking about this particular concept, so you can see here, I'm showing you a particular problem here. So the capital cost of the DG set is how much? It is 9 lakhs. So how much is the annual output? The annual output is 219 megawatt hour. And the maintenance cost is around 30,000 per annum. Clear? So the capital cost of the DG set is coming around, you can see the capital cost is coming around how much? It is 9 lakhs. So the capital cost of the generator, so that is coming under which cost? It will come under your fixed cost. I have made a table by which you can easily understand the concept and you can easily find out the total cost. So the annual output is how much? 219 megawatt hour. So for the DG set is costing 9 lakh rupees. So with the help of that, the output is 219 megawatt per hour. And the maintenance cost per year is 30,000 rupees per year. And the cost for producing each unit is coming around 3.55 rupees per kilowatt hour. So here we are here to find out the total cost of the diesel generator if you are going to operate for five years, taking into consideration both fixed cost and variable cost. So you can see I have generated a table here by virtue of this particular the data that is given over here. So the capital cost of DigiSet is given, the annual output is 219 megawatt hour, maintenance cost per year is 30,000 per annum, and per kilowatt hour the cost is unit cost, the cost of producing each unit of electricity is 3 rupees 50 paise. So what is the total cost for the next 5 years? That is what you are going to find out. So what you are finding, the total cost, so addition of fixed cost plus variable cost. Excuse me. So whatever that has been, you can see in the problem that we have to bifurcate, that we have to actually divide which is fixed and which is variable. So already the capital cost of the generator is fixed cost, which I have put it here, 9 lakhs. So the annual maintenance cost is also coming in the fixed cost. The maintenance is necessary. So 30,000 per year. So 30,000 per annum, it is per year. You can see here, it is given in the question. So for 5 years, as we are calculating the total cost, so annual maintenance cost also you have to calculate for 5 years. So 9 lakhs is your capital cost, which is coming under fixed cost, and annual maintenance cost is 1,50,000, which is coming under the fixed cost. Now the fuel cost. So the fuel cost is your variable cost. So it totally depending upon, it depends upon the annual output. So if the output is changing, the fuel cost also will change. So the annual output is almost 219 megawatt per hour. So as the rate is in kilowatt hour, so I have changed 219 megawatt into 219 into 1000. That is 219 into 1000 kilowatt hour. That multiplied by 3.5 per, that is per kilowatt into 5 years. So it's coming in out 38,32,500. So after total calculation, we are getting around the total cost is how much is this. So if you are going to operate this particular diesel generator for 5 years, so the total cost that it's going to occur is this much, 48,82,500. So from this, what actually we can conclude? The basic idea behind this is, you can see that the fixed cost, when we compare the fixed cost, that is 9 lakhs plus 15,000, these two costs, when we compare with the total cost, it's around 20 to 21% of the total cost. Okay, so you now the output is 219 megawatt hour. Now he assumes that the plant is operating with an average output of how much? The average output when we calculate is coming around 50 kilowatt. So 219 megawatt hour is annual, that is per year. So per day it is 50 kilowatt year, it's coming around average. So if this output you are trying to increase by 70 kilowatt, then ultimately the fuel cost will increase. Okay, no doubt. See, if the output is increased, the fuel cost will increase. Okay, so with that, what will happen? The fixed cost will drop. Now, by this, what we come to conclusion, we can come into to the conclusion that the average unit cost of production decreases as the output increases. Which output? The annual output, the output of the energy output we are talking about. If you want that your average unit cost of production should decrease, your output should increase. Clear? Now this concept of fixed and variable cost, you can also determine by determining, it can also be used to this particular concept of fixed cost, variable cost, you can also use for determining break-even point for this particular project, which proposed project, maybe in the form of a problem, numerical. So that particular break-even point, okay, you can actually calculate. So you know the concept in economics, we have studied that break-even point. The break-even point is that point where there is no neither loss nor profit. Okay, in terms of economics, when we talk about. So let us actually, you can see here, do one thing. Let us let me write a formula is here. You see. This is UC, I have written UTIL suffix. Now UC util is actually what? It is the unit cost. It is the unit cost per kilowatt hour of energy bought from utility. Okay, that is the rupees kilowatt. It is in rupees kilowatt hour. Now you see production. Okay. This is also the unit cost per kilowatt hour of per kilowatt hour of energy. Okay, you see utilities is the unit cost per kilowatt hour of energy brought for utility, and this is the kilowatt hour of produced energy, that is also rupees per kilowatt hour. Yeah, then basically what is FC? FC is the fixed cost, is in rupees, then WAV, W suffix AV is the what? It's the average power output. Okay, average power output, or you can say consumption. In okay, and last one is it is small n. Small n is what? It is the number of hours of operation. This is the most important thing, which our main motto. Okay, so this is actually the with this actually these are actually the parameters by which we are going to calculate. Okay, so the formula is actually just let me put it as simple. So you see util, okay, multiplied by this average W of AV multiplied by N is equal to FC into UC production into WAV into N. So this is the formula. Okay. So UC util into WAV into N is equal to FC into. Yeah. This becomes your formula. Okay. So this is multiplication symbol. Don't confuse. So this particular with the help of this particular formula you can actually now here this is the break even point. You can also determine by using the formula by using this equation you can easily find out what is the break even point. So basing on this, so again you see util is what? Unit cost per kilowatt hour, and how much energy you are buying from utility. And UC production is unit cost per kilowatt hour of how much energy that you are producing. FC is the fixed cost. Okay, you see both are in. You have to equate it here by multiplying with this average power output and the number of hours that you are operating. Yeah, but the fixed cost here, the extra thing is the fixed cost is only multiplied. Here you can see in the right hand side. Okay. Because here we are in the producer's side. Yeah, we are not buying it. Yeah. So let us see a particular example here. So based on this particular first problem which we have just dealt. Yeah, based on this only we will see. If the electricity brought from the utility company is costing an average of rupees 4.5 kilowatt per hour, then the break-even point of the generator is correct as per the previous problem. Clear? When the average output is 50 kilowatt, is given by how much? So that break-even point you have to actually calculate. So based on this particular problem, so let me again. So this problem is actually the base to solve this particular problem. Okay. So if the electricity bought from the utility company costs on average of rupees 4.5, so you're buying the electricity from an utility company. So that is what we talked about. This particular UC utilities. UC is what? Unit cost per kilowatt hour of the energy bought from utility. Clear? So that we are actually talking about. Clear? So based on that, so UC utility is how much? Rupees 4.5. Clear? And average, how much, what is the average here? The break-even point when the average output WAV is nothing but average output, as already we have discussed, that is 50. Now, based on this particular, let us simply substitute the values here. So 4.5 is UC util, that is utility company cost is how much? 4.5 multiplied by the, what is the average output? Average output is 50 multiplied by N, that is what you have to find out. And fixed cost already you know, it is fixed cost is how much? 9 lakhs plus 1,50,000. Okay, so from where this 2 has come, here you can see this 9 lakhs is the capital cost of generator, fixed cost, annual maintenance 1,50,000. This is also coming under your fixed cost. Clear? So this is your fixed cost. Then this fixed cost is multiplied. Okay. I have done a small mistake. Here this fixed cost is added here, not multiplied. Okay. Sorry for the mistake. Fixed cost you have to add. Clear? Please change the form. So fixed cost plus UC production. So this is addition. So what is this production? How much is the production here? The production is how much? 3.5. Clear? As given in the first part of the problem. What is WAV? Same again, 50. Okay. Yeah. So let us try to solve this in the calculator. So it is 9 lakhs plus 1,50,000. So it is 10,50,000. Keep aside. So 3.5 multiplied by 50. So it is 175N 4.5 into 50, 225N, 225N minus 175N equal to 1,50,000. Okay, you can do the calculations. So just you can verify. So 10,50,000. Okay, 225 minus 1,50, 50. So N will be divided by 50. So N will be how much? 21,000 hours. N is equal to 21,000 hours. Okay, so what is N here? So N is the number of hours of operation. Okay, please verify this. By mistake, I have put it as multiplication. This should be addition. So N is the number of hours of operation. So for how much you have to operate, you should operate for 21,000 hours. Okay. That means if the average output is 50 kilowatt. Now, let me take an example. Now, you think that if your average output, this ends the problem. Okay. So continuation, think that the average output, I'll take it as 70 kilowatt. And what will happen to the break-even point? So, the break-even point, the break-even point is given by, so 4.5, same thing. Let us again, instead of, take a look here, instead of 50, it is 70. Rest all remains same. If you take a look, W of AV is only going to change. Rest all are same. So this, when we calculate, okay, so 70 into 4.5, 315 minus 245. It is 70. Yeah. So 10,50,000 divided by 70. So it's coming around how much? N is, you calculate, okay. I have done it. Let's do it in a speedier way. So N you got it as how much? 15,000 hours. So by this you can see, so what is happening, see, the number of operating hours is decreasing. So if you are increasing the average output of the generator, so earlier the average output was how much? Average output of 50 kilowatt. Now I have increased to 70. So when I'm increasing to 70 kilowatt, ultimately what is happening, the average output of generator when you're increasing, so it reduces the break-even time. So that break-even time is actually reduced for that particular project. This is because the capital investment that is the generator is better utilized. Okay, so whatever that you have invested, that is for the on the generator, it is being better utilized. That is our most important point which I want to discuss with you. So increasing the average output ultimately will reduce the break-even time. This is what break-even time. Okay, you can just see for 50 kilowatt output, the break-even time was 21,000 hours operating time, and for 70 kilowatt, when you are increasing, the break-even time has decreased to 15,000 hours. Clear? So N is what? Number of hours of operation. Okay. I hope you have understood this. Clear? So let us meet in the next class. Thank you.